Welcome to Learn Cybersecurity BD. This is MD Joshimuddin welcoming you. This is part of why Linux is so important for cybersecurity. In today's video, I'll let you know the most important and powerful Linux command and why it is essential for ethical hackers, cybersecurity analysts, pen testers, and even hackers. As you may know, Linux is so important for cybersecurity. Linux is treated as the backbone of cybersecurity, and mastering the command can elevate you into the next level. Today, I will describe two crucial points. File and directory management. File and directory management. Navigate, organize, and manipulate. After that, I'll describe networking commands like network tools and troubleshooting of networks. Whether you are a beginner or aspiring ethical hacker, these basics or this video will enhance or gear up your skills, gear up your Linux skills, and will give you the confidence of Linux command users, and it also gear up your basic knowledge of Linux commands. So don't go anywhere, because I am demonstrating each and every commands in real world scenario. If you are interested to boost your Linux skills, can subscribe my channel and hit the like button. So let's dive in. At first, file and directory management command. We came here our Linux machine. As you may know, ls list view, ls used for view the list of directory and files. If I type ls, it will came all the views. Now I'm going to desktop folder or directory, cd directory. Cd means change directory. I'll create a folder that is mkdir for create folder. Test underscore directory. Directory created. As you may know, in Linux machine, folder is called directory. So I am creating a files here. Doc file. Touch is used for creating files. So I am clearing the screen. Command is clear, so screen will be clear. Now I came here in my terminal again and copy the file that I have created earlier. Test underscore file dot doc. Cp copy. Cp used for copying files. And destination folder will be test underscore directory. You have to remember file name and destination directory. Done. Here I have copied the file from desktop to test directory. If I go to test directory from here, cd test directory, and changing the directory here, hitting enter. Now I am in test directory. Look, desktop slash test directory. Now I am doing the ls here. Let's see, file copied, test underscore file dot doc. So file copied from desktop to test directory. If I get the file, that is view the file, as it is empty file, there is no data, so I will give some data, or I will write something on the file. Use for mousepad to edit any text file. To edit any text file, we have to use mousepad file name. So file opened, and after that I will write something here, test file blah blah blah, that I like to write over here something. Save the file and close it. If I close it, if I do the cat again, I'm clearing the screen. I cat the file name. So cat test underscore file dot doc. Here showing the text that I have written few months earlier. So I am changing the directory double dot cd double dot, that will previous folders, go to previous folder, and I'll copy cp test empty dot doc and the destination folder where I am going to copy the folder. Test directory done. I've copied to the test directory and changing my directory cd test directory. I'm clearing the screen, and if I do ls file, I let's see, that is I copied the file and showing the file here in list view ls. Two files here that I have copied, one is empty and one is not empty. So moving we will use mv file name and the destination where we like to move the file. Move is used for cart. If you are a Windows user, you may know move is used for cart. Child slash desktop, that will go through the home folder, and tail desktop is will go to desktop folder. So here I am doing ls here again. I move the file from test directory folder to desktop folder, that is showing the test empty doc is now in desktop folder. PWD means print working directory, that is showing the path of the directory. PWD used for print working directory, present working directory. So I am in test directory here. It's showing. If I do cd here, I'll back the previous directory. Here is PWD again, and that is showing the directory where I am stands. If I do cd and double dot, it will back to another directory, that is desktop directory. Cd dot, if I do finding any file, I have to type find test any file file name first, empty dot doc. That is, you have to mention the file name here, and it is so smooth and so fast. If you are a Windows user, you may find the difference. So cd test directory, I am going to the test directory here and finding the file again in same way, find and file name. It is showing test empty doc. This file is showing. So I am finding the directory from path, finding the file from path. So I am going first test directory. Here is directory that I am searching for. If you search directory, you can use this command to find test directory. It is showing the directory. After that, I am searching the file name from the directory. So I have to type the directory name first and the name of the file. After that, hyphen name test underscore empty doc. This is my file name and the parameter is name. So it is appearing test underscore directory and test underscore empty. Here is the showing the path and the file name also. So I am going to my root directory. Cd tailed is going to root directory. Tail is for going to root directory here. If I do pwd, it is showing I am in home directory, and ls is showing the all files.
So if I want to go public folder and cd desktop, I am going to desktop. Df is used for disk system. H means human readable. Dfh means it will show all the directory sizes and the system file system. Here it is showing and how many space you have rest and the users of the directory here, all the drives is showing in the screen. Df-h. du means disk users. It's used for disk space count or disk space view. du-sh test directory. If I do this command, and it will show the disk directory sizes 4 KB only. du-sh. This command is used for to see the space of any file and folders. So if I do du-sh and the public folder, at first I have to put the tailed symbol public folder. It will go to root folder and public folder. It is also 4 KB. So I want to see you something more. I'm going to the root folder and ls. Here is scrappy. I'll show you the properties and the disk users. So if I do du-sh scrappy, it is showing the 14 MB. If I clear the screen and do the command again, it is showing 14 MB. So the file is scrappy is 14 MB. I am going to the desktop folder, desktop directory, and if I do the du command, I have to mention the path where the file stand for. This is showing tailed means the home folder and slash scrappy, showing the path and showing the properties or showing the spaces of the folder or directory. Stat means status. So if I want to see the status of the folder or file, I can use this command. The stat, the file name or folder name, it is showing all the access permission, where it is modified, changes, and the created. Birth means created for directory created time or directory created hour. After that, I will start tail scrappy. If I do this command, it will show the path that I have given. Tail means home folder, as you may know. It is also showing the all the parameters, all the properties. Now I am doing the rm command. Rm means remove or delete. It is one thing. Remember, if you delete anything from Linux, it will delete it forever. So before delete any file, you have to remember this file will not be used anymore. So rm test, that is I am deleting a file here. Rm test empty. I have deleted the file. I am creating file now. Empty file. Mkdir. Empty directory. I have created an empty directory. For showing, for empty directory deletion purpose, we just use rm directory. Rmdir empty directory. It will be deleted forever. gone. After that, if I do test directory purpose, if I do the rmdir directory name test directory, what happened? It will not be work because it is not empty directory. For this folder, there is a file. If any file exists to the folder or directory, we want to pass a parameter rmrf, that is rf test underscore directory. It will work. Those directories are not empty. We have to put this command for remove this directory, rmrf test directory. It will gone forever. And if I delete or remove the test file here, I'll just type rm test file dot doc. It will gone. So it has been gone and gone forever. This is file and directory folders. There is shortage of time. The video length is more than 16 minutes. So I will part the video two parts. So if you like the video, please subscribe my channel and be with us. Thank you.